Good morning. Welcome to St. James. At this time, I invite you to please visit our website, www.stjames-liberty.org. Again, that is www.stjames-liberty.org. There you will find today's readings and the lyrics to the songs for today's Mass. While there is still no congregational singing at this time, we invite and encourage you to hum along and pray with us. This Thursday, July 2nd, our lunchtime recital series continues and will feature soprano Joanna and her husband and concert pianist Piotr. They will be performing 6 songs for voice and piano by Rachmaninoff and a few other opera favorites. Our lunchtime recital begins at 12 noon, is free, open to the public, and we will also live stream on our Facebook page. Please invite a friend. Current office hours for St. James are 8:30 to 11 a.m. Monday through Friday. Even though we are not selling hope cards after Mass, they are still available. You can purchase them in the parish office, call us and place your order over the phone, or go online to our website. We thank you for your continued support of our Hope program. Today, we celebrate the 13th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Please stand.
Today. I know how much Father Mike and I appreciate the effort that you make to come during this time of the pandemic and how great your faith is. So keep up the good work and may God bless you for all that you do for our parish family. We begin by remembering that we come to the Lord as sinners, always trusting in God's mercy. Lord Jesus, in the waters of baptism, you invite us to be your disciples. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you invite us to welcome all who come into our presence in the spirit of kindness and love. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, the power of your precious blood washes us clean, makes us ready for your kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of light, grant, we pray, that we may not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in the bright light of truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the second book of Kings. One day, Elijah came to Shunem, where there was a woman of influence who urged him to dine with her. Afterwards, whenever he passed by, he used to stop there to dine. So she said to her husband, "I know that Elisha is a holy man of God. Since he visits us often, let us arrange a little room on the roof and furnish it for him with a bed, a table, a chair, and a lamp, so that when he comes to us, he can stay there." Sometime later, Elisha arrived and stayed in the room overnight. Later, Elisha asked, "Can something be done for her?" His servant answered, "Yes. She has no son, and her husband is getting on in years." Elisha said, "Call her." When the woman had been called and stood by the door, Elisha promised, "This time next year, you will be fondling a baby son." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Forever I will see thy A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized unto his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism unto death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in newness of life. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. As to his death, he died to sin once and for all. As to his life, he lives for God. Consequently, you too must think of yourselves as dead to sin and living for God in Christ Jesus, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his apostles, "Whoever loves father or mother more than me is not worthy of me, and whoever loves son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me, and whoever does not take up his cross and follow after me is not worthy of me. Whoever finds his life will lose it, and whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. Whoever receives you receives me, and whoever receives me receives the one who sent me. Whoever receives a prophet because he is a prophet will receive a prophet's reward. And whoever receives a righteous man because he is a righteous man will receive a righteous man's reward. And whoever gives only a cup of cold water to one of these little ones to drink, because the little one is a disciple, amen, amen, I say to you, he will surely not lose his reward." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, there was an item in the internet maybe 3 or 4 weeks ago, maybe you saw it. It was about a change of policy for the Mormons, the Church of Latter-day Saints. It was really kind of a minor change that they were making. As you know, they send out missionaries, two by two, usually two young men. And they're pretty well identified because they always wear black pants and white shirt and black tie, and almost always spot them. The change is that now they were permitted to wear blue shirts with no tie. Well, there was an incident that happened where two of these missionaries, Mormons, went into a neighborhood and they were walking around from house to house. And they came to a house where there was a big mat in front of the door that said, "Welcome." And so they thought, well, this would be a wonderful place to visit. So they rang the doorbell. Eventually, a woman came and she opened the door and she looked up and down at the men and she said, "Are you guys preachers?" And they said, "Well, we represent the Mormon Church and we'd just like to share some literature with you." She looked up and down and she slammed the door in their face. So as they were walking away, one said to the other, "I think they need to change the name on their doormat from welcome to unwelcome." You know, brothers and sisters, hospitality or welcome is a very prominent image in our scripture readings today. I want to really focus on the spirit of hospitality. It's not just about being polite or nice to people. It's a virtue that we all are called to practice as God's people. We heard a reading, an example of that in our first reading today from the Old Testament. And that reading takes us back to about 700-800 years before the birth of Christ, when Elisha the prophet was walking from place to place among the people, calling the people to be faithful to the covenant. And apparently he stopped at the same place on his route several times, and he stopped at this one place in Shunem. And there was a couple there. The woman was called a woman of influence. And so he was welcomed there by this woman and her husband and given a meal. And she said, "I have kind of a surprise for you. We're going to build a little addition onto our house, and you can stay there whenever you pass by." And the prophet was very appreciative. And so he made a decision. He said, "Next year, the year from today, when I come through, you will have a special gift." The woman was childless. They had looked for a child. And he said, "You will be holding a newborn son in your arms." That was the great reward that she received from her spirit of hospitality. And then the gospel today, we hear Jesus said, "In that same vein, whoever welcomes you welcomes me." Jesus is also talking about a spirit of welcome. This thing about receiving meaning in the spirit of great welcome and hospitality. It's a marvelous thing that Jesus says, "Whoever receives you receives me." So he's identifying himself with each one of us. Those who receive us in hospitality receive the very person of Jesus. And obviously, when we receive others, we are also receiving the very person of Jesus. So he's promising to us to be with us at all times and to find his presence in every other person that we encounter. I want to take this idea of hospitality and apply it to four areas of our lives. First of all, our own personal lives. I guess you've all encountered people who are glum and critical and negative and gloomy all the time, and certainly not very good to be in their presence. You don't feel comfortable with them. So we are called upon not to be gloomy and glum all the time, but rather to live with the spirit of welcome. That all of us should be people who have an openness to the presence of others and to welcome them into our presence. So all of us try to be welcoming people, people of hospitality, people of openness and care for others. Then I also want to apply that to our families. Our families that are called upon to be families of hospitality. Now obviously you can't welcome everybody who comes into the door into your house for various reasons, but you can receive them in the spirit of politeness and welcome. Unlike that lady who slammed the door in the face of the missionaries, we welcome people. At least we are respectful to them and see in each person who comes to our door the presence of the Lord in them. So we try to be a family that practices hospitality, a family of welcome. A few years ago, I was visiting a family and who had invited me to come to see them. It was a husband and wife. And so I was invited in, and the television set was blaring away, and I thought, well, surely they will turn the television set down and turn it off. But no, it kept blaring away, and you could hardly carry on a conversation. It wasn't a very good spirit of hospitality. So we looked for little ways in which we could welcome people into our homes and express to them our love and our care for them. The third thing would be hospitality within our parish family. I think we do a really good job here at St. James, extending our arms in hospitality to people who come to us. Father Mike is always there welcoming people. We have ushers, we have greeters, we have people who answer questions. So we really try as a parish family to practice hospitality and welcome. Some parishes are not like that. You feel a sort of coldness and indifference there. So we really try as a parish family to remember that all of us are ministers of hospitality. All of us show a spirit of welcome to others. The final thing would be to make the application to our universal church family. As a Catholic church family, we are called to be a welcoming church. I think we are very fortunate to have Pope Francis. Pope Francis is a very open-minded, welcoming sort of person. Recently, Pope Francis met with other religious leaders that came together to pray for all those who were victims of the pandemic. And a lot of people were criticizing, some people were criticizing Pope Francis because he was praying with outsiders, with people of other religions. But I think he was giving us a wonderful example of how we find the presence of Christ, not just in our own, but people that may be very much different than we are. So brothers and sisters, I think that's the wonderful message proclaimed to us today. We are called to be people of hospitality. That woman in the first reading today did not expect anything for showing the prophet this meal and this welcome. We may not expect anything for what we do, and yet the Lord makes this great promise to all of us: I will prepare a room for you in the kingdom, my heavenly home. So brothers and sisters, let us all really strive hard to hear this word of God today and to practice the spirit of hospitality.
I just would like to take a moment following Father Michael's homily to share with you and ask your prayers for Monsignor William Blassett. Monsignor Blassett was died this past Sunday, and he was a longtime pastor here at St. James during my grade school and high school years from about 1958 till 1960. And St. James was just a very small parish off the square in a very Baptist town at that time. And so Monsignor was a fairly young pastor. This was his first assignment as a pastor, and he brought a lot of energy and dynamism to our parish and led us through the changes of the church during the Second Vatican Council, and was just a very dynamic man. Well, he has been a priest for 73 years, and he was close to 99 years old when he died last Sunday. And he'd been a priest for 73 years of his life, and most recently has served as pastor of Our Lady of Good Counsel since 1992 in Westport, where he turned that community into a shrine of divine mercy. And Monsignor Blassett has had a tremendous influence in our diocese and with many young men considering the priesthood. And so we just lift him up in prayer and thank him for being such a good and faithful shepherd and pastor to our community for so long, and we ask for God's continued blessings and peace upon him. Also, I just want to say a word of, if it feels a little stuffy in church, our internet was hit by the storm on Friday night, and luckily the power didn't go off, but lots of other stuff did that I have no idea about. But they're doing the best they can to get us going, so the air conditioning is as best as it can be right now. So, but we realize how humid and hot out it is, but I always hate to say that because then people feel hotter than they should. So in one sense, I wanted to ignore it, but then people would be leaving and going, well, I know we're conserving money, but why don't we have the church a little cooler? So we just want to keep all of that in mind and just know that we're on top of things, but you know, we just, some things were out of our control. So again, thank you for your patience and trust.
I believe
in one God, the Father, the Almighty,
maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God and true God, begotten not made, and sustained by the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Brothers and sisters, believing in the light of Christ, which banishes all darkness, let us bring our needs and the needs of our world before the Lord.
That all who are not baptized will, through the preaching of the church, be led to accept the grace and call of God to receive his new life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For nations torn apart by the ravages of civil war, may civilians be protected and peace restored. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the strength to welcome Christ as he comes to us in the stranger, the sick, the imprisoned, and the unborn child, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the millions of refugees in the world may receive brotherly love and concrete aid from all Christians, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For young people seeking direction in their lives, may they be emboldened to take up their crosses and follow the Lord of life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all in our parish and families who are sick, especially those affected by COVID-19, and for our departed loved ones, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intention of this Mass, whom we hold in prayer, Christy Kuntz. For those on the St. James prayer chain, and for the prayers we hold in the silence of our hearts, for all of these, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Monsignor Blassett, that he may receive eternal life and peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer.
Creator God, you have made the world and all that is in it, and proclaim that it is good. Hear our prayers that as faithful disciples, we may take on the task of restoring and repairing creation through the work of our hands. Through this, we ask through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours would be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of our peace, for the praise of the Lord and his name, for our good and for all his church.
Amen. O God, who graciously accomplished the effects of your mysteries, grant, we pray, that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of these sacred gifts. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured the Passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and saints we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all that you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. His wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, the for the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. James, our parish patron, and all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and James our Bishop, with the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for you. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed with divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us share a sign of peace with one another.
We pray. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, Come, at least spiritually, into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Behold the Lamb of God, the Lamb who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
As you come forward for communion, we remind you to please put your mask on and observe the markings on the floor to maintain a safe 6-foot distance from the person in front of you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Let us pray. May this divine sacrifice we have offered and received fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.